Hi, this is JP from Not Allowed Over Arkham. This time I'm continuing Sister Mary's run through the Return to Dunwich Legacy campaign, and we are playing the Winchester Mary version of Sister Mary. I only got 2 experience from the last scenario, so let's look at the deck upgrade first. The only upgrade into the deck was that I removed the 1 premonition and I added 1 vicious blow level 2 into the deck, as there are high health enemies in this scenario, the vicious blow surely will come into good use. But other than that, the deck remains quite the same. We have all of the story asset allies in the deck, and we don't have the Necronomicon. So let's go back to the scenario. Because we released 3 of the monsters into the wild in last scenario, we have 3 doom on the agenda when we start. We also need to add a -5 token into the bag at the start of the scenario. Also, because we defeated or we put Silas Bishop out of his misery, we have the conglomeration of spears in the play, and it starts at the ascending path, so that will come towards us right away, so we better find some way to deal damage to that soon enough, so we don't have to waste 2 turns just hitting it. I think that's pretty much everything about the deck and the scenario, so let's get started. We have pre-shuffled the deck, so I'll draw our opening hand of 5 cards. Okay, well, we drew the weakness, so we shuffle that, but we get the Winchester. So actually this hand looks pretty good. We can basically one-shot the conglomeration of spears in one shot with the Winchester, so I'm keeping the Winchester, all in my pride. I think I can shuffle the take the initiative, and we could fish for something else. So I'll reshuffle those, so we get Calling in Favors and another Winchester. So we have the weapons side of the deck at hand right at the start, which is really nice. I think I'm just getting 1 resource, playing Olive and playing the Winchester and letting the enemy come to me and start shooting it next turn. Okay, so first action, I'll get a resource. Second action, let's play the Winchester. And last action, I'll play Olive McBride. And that is our turn. Enemy phase. The enemy hunts here, engages us, hits us for 1 damage and 1 horror. I'll take the horror on Olive McBride, and the damage, I have to take it on myself. Nothing else happens. We go to upkeep. We draw a card. We get the scene of the crime. We get 1 resource. Unfortunately, we don't have enough to play scene of the crime next turn to get 2 clues, but it is what it is. And we add 1 less token into the chaos bag. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. encounter card is explicable cold. Test agility 4. For each point you fail by, you must either choose and discard one card from your play area or from your hand or take one damage. I really don't have much. Well, I have cards to boost it with, but they are both single resources, so no point. I am testing a 3 versus 4. It's a minus 1, so we have to discard 2 cards from our hand. I think I'm fine discarding calling it favors and the other. I'll discard the scene of the crime. We really want to keep hold of the other Winchester. Just if we run out of ammo, we have to have another weapon at the ready. First action, I'll use Olive. And I'll use the vicious blow and shoot with the Winchester. Actually, if I hit with the Winchester, I'm dealing 3 damage. So we, I'll have to shoot again. So I'll save the vicious blow for now. So we get an Elder sign. So we hit and we add a bless token in the back, and we deal 3 damage. Second action, I will commit the vicious. I forgot I was using Olive. Let's back up a bit. So we got the Elder sign. Still need to resolve 2 other tokens. I'll just remove the one less token that I pulled. Okay, so the other 2 tokens with Olive were minus 2 and a skull. Skull is a minus 1 because we're not in an altered location, so I'll discard this and keep these. We still add the bless token and hit. Second action, we'll shoot again. And this time I'm using the vicious blow just in case, because we are only drawing 1 card, so I'm hoping to deal 3 damage. And it's a plus 1, so we actually managed to deal 4 damage. So we also deal plus 2 damage instead of 1 with this, because we succeeded by 2 or more. So this enemy is defeated. Last action, I think I'm drawing a card. We really need to find some way to investigate so we can get advancing. Prepared for the worst, not that useful. No enemies, we go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get Dr. Francis Morgan, good health soak, we add 1 less token to the back, and we gain 1 resource. That is that turn, let's go to the next turn. We add a doom, the encounter card is Avian Troll. Okay, well, Avian Troll is a 5 fight, 4 health and 3 evade enemy. Prey lowest intellect hunter, while Avian Troll is being attacked using a range firearm or spell asset, gets minus 3 fight. Okay, well, these enemies are really slowing us down. So I think we just have to start shooting. So I'm shooting with the Winchester. I'm using Olive. Zero, minus 3, minus 3, so I'll remove the minus 3. We hit a non-negative modifier. And we are shooting 5 versus 3. Versus 2, so we still hit, even with the minus 3. So we deal 3 damage. And unfortunately we have to shoot again. I can't afford to miss. And it's minus 3 to the enemy's fight if we use the ranged weapon or firearm. An auto fail. Well, that sucks. We'll have to just try again. And it's a cultist. Reveal another token. Cancel the effects and icon speed skill card committed to this test. And it's a non-negative modifier. A minus 2. So we still hit and we deal 3 damage. It doesn't matter because it only has 1 health remaining. But that was our whole turn and we are still not in any way closer to getting these clues and advancing. Enemy phase, nothing happens. Upkeep, we draw a card. We hit the Crisis of Fate. We have 5 blessed tokens in the bag. I think I'm taking the Horror. We don't really want to. At least I'm taking 3 Horror, so let's change 2 of the blessed tokens. Okay, so we lose 2 blessed tokens. We add 2 curse tokens. Then at the end of the round, we add 1 more blessed token into the back. Crisis of Fate resolved. So, that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a Doom. The encounter card for this turn is Research and Evils. I'll just add the Doom. I don't want any more encounter cards to resolve. I'm actually just looking for ways to investigate, so we find Dr. Henry Armitage, Rite of Sanctification, and I'm just pulling cards, deny existence a bit too late. Still no good way to investigate. But maybe next turn. No enemies, we go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get Zebulon Wheatley. We gain 1 resource and put 1 more blessed token in the back. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 8 of 12 Doom. The encounter card is Beyond the Veil. Well, we don't really mind as long as we have the deny existence in hand. We can just ignore the damage. That is the mythos phase. Let's see what we can do. First action, I'll play Rite of Sanctification. I'll put 3 blessed tokens onto it. I think that is enough. I can just find the third one. Here it is. Second action, I will. I'm playing I'll play Dr. Francis Morgan and we'll use this. No, let's not play Dr. Francis yet. We'll play the other Winchester. And I'll use one of these blessed tokens to cheapen it. This goes into the discard. We get 5 more ammunition. And last action. I think I'm trying investigating. I just have to do something. I used Dr. Henry Armitage and prepared for the worst. And I'll use Olive. So we hopefully hit a Bless token. So I'm investigating 5 versus... Five versus four. Okay, well, we'll try it at least. So I'm keeping these. Let's see where they go. So we get Bless token. Plus one. Okay, and okay. So this is -7. So we are at 5 versus 4. Yeah. 5 versus 9, 11. So we are at 10. So we fail. I'll use this Sacred Covenant. So this curse token goes away. These go back into the bag. So I just fail the investigation. Get one curse token out of the bag. That is our turn. We have no enemies, we go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get another prepared for the worst, gain one resource, we ready up our cards, and we put one blessed token into the bag. That is that turn, let's go to the next turn. We are at 9 doom of 12, counter card is Rites Hold. Hex Revelation, discard the top 3 cards of each investigator's deck. Each investigator at an altered location shuffle each weakness in his or her discard pile into his or her deck. So we just discard 3 cards. And we luckily didn't. We lost Ward of Protection, Hallowed Mirror, and Lesson Learned. So luckily we didn't lose any of our investigated cards except the Lesson Learned. First action. I think I'm playing... I'll play... Dr. Francis Morgan? No. Let's hold on. If we find an investigative card... Well, we get Earl Sawyer. We hit Across Space and Time, discard the top 3 cards of your deck. Okay. Hopefully we don't lose. Well, goddammit, we lost Sixth Sense, Drawn to the Flame, and Deny Existence. Nothing we can do about that. Okay. Last action, just dig for investigative cards. That seems to be our story for this game. We have 4 allies in hand, no way to investigate better, and no enemies. We go to upkeep, we draw a card. Well, finally we get something, we get evidence, so some intellect symbols. We gain one resource and we put one less token into the bag. That is that turn, let's go to the next turn. We add a doom to the agenda. We are at 10 of 12. Altered Beast. If there are no abomination enemies in play, Altered Beast gains search. Resurgent Evils. I'll just add the doom. We can't afford to get 2 encounter cards at the moment. Okay. First action, we'll investigate. I'll commit evidence and Earl Sawyer and prepare for the worst for this test. So I'm investigating 4, 5, 6 versus 4. It's a plus 1, so we get one clue and forced up. Here we put one of the diverging path locations into play at random. So finally we can get going. I'll just place here. Okay, so we get this location. I think we are just moving there. So second action will move here. Of course, it after you reveal destroy path, place one doom on it. If you succeed, instead of discovering clues, remove one of your one doom from destroyed path. Well, this sucks a lot. That actually doesn't matter, because we are at the witching hour, so the doom is irrelevant. We'll just move back to the base of the hill. And that is our turn. No enemies, we go to upkeep, we draw a card. Finally we get something useful, we get a drone to the plane. And we gain one resource and we place one S token into the back. Okay, so we have Drawn to the Flame, Olive McBride, Francis Morgan, Zebulon Wheatley, and Deny Existence in hand. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a Doom, so we go over the threshold. Okay. So the world is altered. Shuffle the encounter discard pile into the encounter deck. And deckoning for power. And a lot of fluff text. And we have a doom threshold of 10. So now we only have 9 more turns to get to the Sentinel Peak, which isn't looking great, but let's see what we can do. We draw our encounter card, and it is a Resurgent of Evils. Just have to add the doom. That sucks, but nothing I can do. First action, drawn to the flame. We discover 2 clues. If we survive the encounter card, it is Vortex of Time. Each investigator at Sentinel Hill location gets a test willpower 4. Each investigator who fails takes 2 damage. I am testing 4, 5, I'll just test 5 versus 4. It's a minus 1, so we pass. And we get those clues, and those clues turn into these locations. Just put them play here. Next, we'll move to this location. It's a forced shot location with 1 clue. Forced after you reveal Eerie Glade, discard the top 2 cards of your deck for each action you have remaining. So we have 1 action remaining. We lose Scene of the Crime and Ward Protection. He really would have wanted the Scene of the Crime. Last action, I think I am trying to actually, just in case I hit something that was a lot of health, I play Dr. Francis Morgan using the Rite of Sanctification, so it costs 1 resource. That is that turn. No enemies, we go to upkeep. We draw the tower. And we add 1 bless token into the bag. And we gain 1 resource. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom to the agenda. Encounter card for this turn is a troll location with the most clues, so it spawns into our location and engages us. That isn't a problem. We have plenty of firepower to deal with the troll. First action, we'll just shoot the troll. I am shooting 6 versus 2. And I'm using Olive. So we hit a less token and 2 minus 1s. We'll keep those. And see where the blessed token goes. So it's minus 2, so we hit, but we have a modifier that is not negative, so we lose the blessed token. The troll is killed, and we can exhaust Dr. Francis Morgan to draw a card, and we get take the initiative. I can't commit cards, so I'll just use the right of sanctification to play the tower. And last action, I think I'm just drawing a card. Another take the initiative, so we at least have some way to get clues on our first action on each turn. No enemies, we go to upkeep. We get another weapon, and we get one resource, and we put one blessed token into the bag. So a reminder, we have 9 blessed tokens in the bag, 1 cursed token, and that's it. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. Encounter card is an avian troll. Well, goddammit. I think I have to take one attack of opportunity here, so that I'll investigate. I'll take 1 damage on Dr. Francis Morgan and 1 horror on myself. This is just because we really need to get this one clue before we do anything else. And we are investigating 5 versus 4. So let's see if I have anything else to commit. No. I think I have to use Olive. So we definitely will hit some blessed tokens. Okay, we didn't hit blessed tokens, but we can pick these two, so it's a minus 1, so we succeed and get this clue. And second action, we'll shoot at the avian troll. 5 versus 2, 6 versus 2. Oh yeah, 6 versus 2 with Francis Morgan. So we hit, we deal 1 damage. We'll shoot again. Okay, so a blessed token, so we at least kill that thing if we hit. And a 0. So actually we can return the blessed token. So I'll put it back. We kill the troll. And I'll draw a card. Francis Morgan. That is our turn. We are really losing turns here, but nothing we can do about it. No enemies, we go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get the right of sanctification. At least it's a intellect symbol. We gain 1 resource, and we put 1 blessed token into the bag. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom, so we are at 4 of 10. Encounter card is Lupin Troll. Spawns at the farthest location, which is luckily up there, so we don't have to deal with that right away. Okay, and first action, it will move to the other diverging path, so abandoned camp. Forced after you reveal abandoned camp, lose 2 resources for each action you have performed this round, so I lose 2 resources. That's not big of a deal. There is a clue here, and a shroud of 2, so second action we are investigating. I'll commit to take the initiative. I think that's good enough. This should be readied. We'll use Olive here again. So we hit a minus one, minus three, a minus zero, or a zero. We'll return the minus three, so we succeed. This should be a clue token, not a wound. So we get the clue. And we'll advance. Yeah, we have to advance immediately. So a sacrifice made. The arcane presence making the path further up the hill has faded. Reveal a scanning path. Remove all clues from each location. There are none. Then, last action, we'll move to the base of the hill. The looping troll will hunt here. We go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get Professor Warren Rice. We don't have any blessed tokens to add, so we just get one resource. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add the fifth doom, the encounter card is violent commands. Put violent commands into play in your threat area, deal 2 damage to an investigator's location, discard violent command. At the end of your turn, test willpower 3, if you fail, take 1 horror. Well, it's just don't care about this one. First action, we'll move up the hill. Oh, there are 3 clues here. So this looping troll engages us. We'll shoot. I'll use Olive. We hit bless tokens, so we discard this one. So let's see. First bless token is a minus 2, so it's 0 basically. And the second one is plus 1, so we hit, and we can actually return the one of these back into the bag. And we kill off the looping troll. We draw a card with Francis Morgan. We get extra ammunition. Nice. And then we investigate. I'm committing Professor Warren Rice to the test. I commit Rite of Sanctification. And Zebulon. So we need 2 clues to get up the hill, but again, if we discover clues here, we just put the locations in play, and this time alter that locations. I am investigating 6 versus 4. We hit a bless token. Cultist. Bless token. Okay. The minus 1, so we succeed, but these bless tokens are removed from the bag. Okay, actually now I have to count, because I just noticed that these icons don't count, so there's 4 icons here. We get the plus 3, so we still succeed, right? Yeah, okay, we get the 1 clue, so the 1 clue turns into a location. And And I think we'll move into that location. No, we don't have actions left, so we moved in, shot, and investigated. So we are at the upkeep. Oh yeah, at the end of the turn, just this card. So 4 versus 3, and it's a Elder Sign. We add a bless token to the back, and we don't take a damage. We draw a card. We get Radiant Smite, which will be helpful if we ever get up the hill. And I think that is that turn. Yeah, we get a resource and add one more bless token. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a Doom. We are at 6 of 10 Doom. Encounter card is Light of Aphorgormon. So you must attach Light of Aphorgormon to either the current agenda or the current act. Treat all damage and as direct damage and horror as direct horror. So we'll attach it to the attach it to here. Then first action will move here. Should we try something else? Let's just move here. And we have actions remaining, so we don't take the damage here. We don't have a great way to investigate this location, so I think I'm just drawing a card. Oh, Guardian Angel, nothing useful. So we really need to find the other 6 turns to have a fighting chance to get these clues, but unfortunately we are not getting it. We go to upkeep, we draw a card. Atycophobia. And we gain 1 resource and 1 less token. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a Doom to the agenda. We are at 7 of 10. Encounter card is Spaces Between. Flip each non-Sentinel Hill location in play to its unbuilt side. Removing all clues from it, each investigator at enemy at the location flipped in this way immediately moves to the nearest Sentinel location. Okay. So these get shuffled. We actually could just go and try get clues of these locations. Well, we know that this is what location this is. Okay, that is the Mythos phase. We'll just draw a card, we get the 6th sense, we'll play the 6th sense, I'll investigate. I'll use Olive. I'm using the 6th sense, so 4 versus 4, and I'll commit a Guardian Angel to the test, so 6 versus 4, it's a blessed token, another blessed token, oh yeah, this is the Olive reveal, so minus 4, we just know the minus 4. And we get curse and a 0, minus 2, so this is a minus 2, this is a plus 2, so we succeed. I can return 1 with the Sacred Covenant. We get 1 clue, which turns into a location. Just put this one in play. So that was the first action. Second action will move into this location. No, first action was play the Sixth Sense. Second action was investigate. Third action is to move. Okay, so we find the dimensional gap. First, after you reveal dimensional gap, discard cards from the top of the encounter deck until an enemy is discarded. Spawn that enemy here instead of its normal spot. Well, that is annoying. And it's a conglomeration of spears. Well, of course it is. We are not gonna make it, I can tell you that. Unfortunate, but it is what it is. Sometimes Arkham Horror is not just in any way fair. But at least we can try to kill it with these Radiant Smites. Enemy phase, we take one damage and one horror from the conglomeration of spears. Upkeep. We are drawing card, we take one horror, shuffle our deck. And beyond the veil triggers, but we'll use the deny existence. So we don't take any damage from that. Oh yeah, and all damage is direct, so sorry. Can't put the damage on you, Dr. Francis Morgan. Okay, and we'll get one resource, we put one token in the back. We test this actually before we put the one token, so just a moment. And it's a bless token. Another bless. Okay, well, it's a skull. We are at an altered location where we succeed. These get removed. At the end of the round, we add one token and we don't take the horror. Okay, there's one clue here. So, that was that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 8 of 10 doom. We are running out of time. Encounter card is Lupin Troll. I'll just put it somewhere here. So, first action. We'll Radiant Smite. I'll get 3 bless tokens from the back after this. I'm using my doesn't matter. I'll just use my willpower. The bless token. The 0. I'll return the bless token back. These get returned in the back and the conglomeration takes 4 damage. Second action, we'll shoot it. I'll use Olive. So we get I'm ignoring this one, so let's just resolve this. Okay, so we get a hit, it kills the enemy, we draw a card with Francis, and we get one bless token to the back. Okay, last action we'll investigate, and I'll commit Zebulon to the test. It's a 0, we get this clue. We still need one clue, but unfortunately we will run out of time next turn. But that's life. We'll test the violent commands. It's a -2, we take one horror. That is that turn. We'll go to upkeep. Tidying this up a bit. Draw a card, a scene of the crime. We get one resource and one bless token into the back. Ok, Okay, well, that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Okay, well, we are at 9 doom of 10, and counter card is Need for Knowledge. If you have no clues, Need for Knowledge can search, otherwise test Intellect X, where X is the number of clues you have. So I have 1. For each point you fail, but I take 1 horror. So I'm testing 2 versus 1. A blessed token. Minus 1, so we pass. I'll just return this to the back. Okay. First action will move here. Oh yeah, this troll would have hunted here last turn. And I have actions, so I don't take the damage. I'm investigating, I'm committing Radiant Smite to the test. And investigating 5 versus 3 using Olive. So bless, and plus 1. Bless. Okay, just ignore these. So we lose these blesses. I know I did this a bit wrong, but I don't really care. I'm losing the game this round, so we get this clue. Last action, we'll just move here, and that is it. So, enemy phase, this troll here hits us. 1 damage and 1 horror direct. And that is it. So, upkeep, we draw a card. 1 resource, 1 blessed token into the back, ready everything, and I won't even cut to the next round, so we add a doom, we advance, so the reward for servitude. The chanting reaches its climax, and at the summit of Sentinel Hill, a tear opens across the fabric of the sky, parting the clouds and slicing through the very air itself. You watch as an indescribable entity, spheres, eyes, mouths, ooze, pours out of the rift. The sorcerers call its name as its form seeps into the sky, spreading forth above the earth, Yog-Sothoth, before their jubilant chant can continue, they are smothered by the growing mass and are heard no more. To your horror, the expansion of the mass does not cease. Resolution 2. So, Resolution 2. The sorcerers from Dunwich, seeking arcane power from beyond this realm, have accomplished what Wilbur and all Wheatley could not. Through blood sacrifice and indescribable experiments, the dark power the sorcerers sought is now within their reach. However, they will never get the chance to truly wield this power. In besieging Wilbur's father for knowledge, they have drawn the creature forth from its extra-dimensional realm. Yog-Sothoth emerges from the open rift above Sentinel Hill, blotting out the sky and enveloping the world. Now it has come to Earth and it rules where humanity once tread. In your campaign log, record that Yog-Sothoth tore apart the barrier between worlds and became one with all reality. Each investigator is driven insane. Each investigator loses the campaign. So, that was a frustrating game because we just lost so much time looking for ways to investigate at the start, so we ran out of time. If we would have had, like, maybe a couple of more turns, we could have got to the Sentinel Peak, and we need to get 2 clues off of there, and actually, yeah, we need 2 clues to advance there, and also we he kills that bishop, we get more more victory points, and we could have killed Seth with just Radiant Smite. But it is what it is. I actually forgot this even was in play. I think I failed some test somewhere and would have turned insane, but it doesn't matter. We lost either way. Still, I really like playing Winchester Mary. I think it's a fun and quirky archetype for Sister Mary builds to play her as a gun-wielding nun. Actually, I think the Mythos posters were talking about Sister Mary, and I could have also make a dual-wielding Sister Mary by adding a bandolier level 2 into the deck, so I could have two Winchesters in play, but I don't see the reason for that. Of course, it provides another health soak, but other than that, well, it gives, I think it boosts willpower by one, so it would help. But yeah, hope you guys like this campaign series of the Return to Dunwich Legacy. Thanks for watching, and until next time.